Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome to Ummah Radio. You are listening to the Tafseer class with myself, Abu Musab. Now, as you know, we are doing the kitab known as Mukhtasar Tafseer ibn Kathir, the abridged version of Tafseer ibn Kathir of Imam ibn Kathir, rahimahullah. We are still busy with volume number one because we are doing the three volume abridged version. And in this one, we had previously completed the Tafseer of Surah Al-Fatiha, and in our last week's class we had completed ayah number 41 of this surah. So that on, if you are following up in this particular print of the kitab, we are beginning on page 58 tonight, inshallah, at the beginning of ayah number 42 and 43 of Surah Al-Baqarah. So then, without further delay, we can begin. Bismillah walhamdulillahi wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. So Allah says in these two ayat, Allah says, وَلَا تَلْبِسُوا الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُوا الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. That do not cloak the truth in falsehood and conceal the truth while you know it. And establish salah and give the zakah. وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ, literally if you were to do it, it means to, and make ruku' with those who make ruku', meaning, and perform salah. But what is actually meant by this here is, join that group of people who are those who make ruku' and sujood and everything like that, meaning become a Muslim. So perform the salah, give the zakah, and become a Muslim, if you were to explain it in simple terms. Those are now ayah number 42 and number 43. So let's move on to the tafsir quickly. He says, يقول تعالى ناهيا لليهود عما كانوا يتعمدونه من تلبيس الحق بالباطل وتمويهه به. He says that Allah Ta'ala says, as a means of forbidding the Jews upon that things which they were doing intentionally by cloaking the truth with falsehood and trying to disguise it with it. وكتمانهم الحق وإظهارهم الباطل. They would conceal the truth and they would openly expose falsehood. So they would make it seem as though the falsehood is the truth, and they would hide the truth as though that was now something of falsehood. They would do things the opposite way around. So for that reason, that is why Allah tells them here, وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُوا الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. He says, فَنَهَاهُمْ عَنِ شَيْئَيْنِ مَعًا وَأَمْرَهُمْ بِإِظْهَارِ الْحَقِّ وَالتَّصْرِيحِ بِهِ. He says, Allah Ta'ala prohibited them from two things together and commanded them to openly bring forth the truth and to be explicit about it. What are the two things? Is do not cloak the truth with falsehood and do not conceal the truth. Those are the two things Allah prohibited them from. Okay, we'll go a little bit into the tafsir here in a bit, so I'm not going to mention it over here. Anyway, he says, وَلِهَذَا قَالَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسِ رضي الله عنهما ولا تلبس الحق بالباطل أي لا تخلط الحق بالباطل والصدق بالكذب. He says it is for this reason that Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he commented on this ayah, ولا تلبس الحق بالباطل. He say, do not mix the truth with falsehood and mix the truthfulness with lies. So some of what you are saying is correct and others is falsehood. Some of what you are saying is the truth and some of what you are saying is lies. So you're mixing truth and lies to give a distorted picture to the people. He says, وَقَالَ أَبُو الْعَلِيَا لَا تُخَلِّطُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَأَدُّ النَّصِيحَةَ لِعِبَادِ اللَّهِ مِنْ أُمَّةِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمِ. He says that Imam Abu al-Aliya rahimahullah, he commented and saying, do not mix the truth with falsehood, and وَأَدُّ النَّصِيحَةَ, and give off nasiha to the Ibadillah, to the servants of Allah from the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, nasiha, again, you can look at it in two ways. One, the linguistic, literal meaning, as we know, nasiha meaning good advice, and give good advice to the Muslims. Another meaning, which, as we know, the hadith, that ad-deenun nasiha, that the deen is nasiha, and one of the meanings, as we did in the tafsir of that hadith, is that nasiha, that nasiha is to be truthful, to be sincere, and all those sort of things. That is also part of the meanings of nasiha. Alright, quick question over here. does this include a half lie and half truth as well? Yes, that would also be included in it, where you are speaking. In fact, that is what you are, how you mix the truth with falsehood. By basically, it's you mixing, whether it's one lie and one truth, or 99 lies and one truth, or 99 truth and one lie. But in any case, you're mixing the two things there. And what Allah is trying to get from you is to speak 100% truth. That is what is being meant over here. Alright, so continuing further, he says, وَقَالَ قَتَادَ وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْيَهُودِيَّةَ وَالنَّصْرَانِيَّةَ بِالْإِسْلَامِ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ دِينَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَأَنَّ الْيَهُودِيَّةَ وَالنَّصْرَانِيَّةَ بِدْعَةٌ لَيْسَتْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. He says that Imam Qatada rahimahullah commented on the ayah, وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ, saying, do not cloak Judaism and Christianity with Islam, while you know that the deen of Allah is only Islam, and that Judaism and Christianity are innovations which are not from the side of Allah. Now, if you remember what I mentioned in a previous class, that when I spoke on Judaism and Christianity having been the religions from Allah, I mentioned over there that I used those terms, Judaism and Christianity, just to make it understandable in today's context, but that the deen has always been Islam from Allah. So here is a like manner, is that what the Jews are upon today and what they were upon in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as well as the Christians, that was not the religion sent down by Allah, but rather that was their own innovated beliefs which they had brought about. They turned away from the Torah, they turned away from the Injil, they turned towards their own innovative things and started doing their own stuff. So that stuff that they were doing was an innovation, it was not from the side of Allah. Now they tried to make it seem to the people as though that which they were doing was in fact part of the deen of Allah. Continuing further, he says, عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما, that Hadhrat Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he commented on وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, and you conceal the truth while you know. He says, لَا تَكْتُمُوا مَا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ الْمَعْرِفَةِ بِرَسُولِي وَبِمَا جَاءَ بِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ تَجْرُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَكُمْ فِيمَا تَعْلَمُونَ مِنَ الْكُتُبِ الَّتِي بِأَيْدِيكُمْ. He says that Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he had said, commenting on this ayah, he says, do not conceal that which you have by you, of the ma'rifah, that you recognize the knowledge you have of my messenger, meaning of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that which you find written in your books, which you know yourselves is in your books, which is in front of you. Meaning, do not conceal the fact that the signs and the description and things of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is there in front of you in the Torah and in your other books which Allah has sent down to you. You find the description and everything mentioned word for word, description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in your books. So you recognize, that's why Allah had said that they recognize Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam as though the way a person recognizes their own child. So clear were the signs that Allah had given to them. But they hid all of these things. So this was a warning from Allah to them, that do not hide these things here while you know that this is the truth and is even mentioned in your books itself. He goes further. He says, وَقَالَ مُجَاهِدْ وَالسُّدِي وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقَ يَعْنِي مُحَمَّدًا صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Imam Mujahid and Imam As-Sudi rahimahumullah, they commented on وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقَ. He say, what is the truth that you hide? He says, it is the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, meaning you hide the truth about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which obviously now is in your books. Now Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he comments now, he says, قُلْتُ وَتَكْتُمُ يَحْتَمِلُ أَن يَكُونَ مَجْزُومًا وَيَحْتَمِلُ أَن يَكُونَ مَنْصُوبًا أي لَا تَجْمَعُوا بَيْنَ هَذَا وَهَذَا كَمَا يُقَالُ لَا تَأَكُلْ السَّمَكَ وَتَشْرَبْ لَا تَأَكُلِ السَّمَكَ وَتَشْرَبْ اللَّبْنَ. His Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he now goes from a linguistic perspective. He says that this taktumu, it's possible it can have a sakin on it, and it's possible that it can also have like a fatha on it. Whether it have a sakin or a fatha would give it two different meanings. That's why he's saying both ways are possible. So what is being said here is, don't do this and this as well. Meaning, don't cloak the truth with falsehood and conceal the truth as well. So these are two separate things. He says, like how the statement is used, don't eat fish and drink milk. If you look at it, it can be like this. don't eat fish and don't drink milk, or don't eat fish but you can drink milk, if you see the slight distinction between the two. So anyway, what he's saying is that it can be like this in two ways. That's basically what he's trying to say from a linguistic perspective. That what it's actually saying is that don't cloak the truth with falsehood, and do not conceal the truth either while it is something that you do know. He goes for this. قال الزمخشري وفي مصحف ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه وتكتم الحق أي في حال كتمانكم الحق وأنتم تعلمون حال أيضا ومعناه وأنتم تعلمون الحق ويجوز أن يكون المعنى وأنتم تعلمون ما في ذلك من الضرر العظيم على الناس. Okay, what's the question over here? What's the difference between cloaking the truth and covering the truth? The difference is, one thing is cloaking the truth. It's not just cloaking the truth, it's تلبس الحق بالباطل. You are cloaking the truth with falsehood. So you mix, basically, if you put it in other terms, you mix the truth with falsehood. You mix the truth with lies. That's the first part. تكتم الحق is where just simply concealing the truth. You are not. Let's say, for example, someone comes to you and they ask you concerning a particular issue. Now you give them a little bit of truth and you also throw a whole lot of lies in along it, and you give them an entirely different verdict. That's cloaking the truth in falsehood. So part of it was correct, but the rest of it was lies or whatever it is. That is cloaking the truth in falsehood. Another way is somebody asks you something and it's like, I don't know, ask somebody else. That is simply just concealing the truth. You're not cloaking it in anything, you're just simply concealing it. That's the difference between the two. Alright, so where were we? We were here now on the point that Imam Az-Zamakhshari rahimahullah had commented. He said that in the Mus'haf of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he had said that, or rather, like the tafsir of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu on وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقِّ, you say, أَيْ فِي حَالِ كِتْمَانِكُمُ الْحَقِّ. In this state, وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقِّ, meaning, and you conceal the truth, he say, it is in this state that you are concealing the truth. وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ is another state, meaning you are in the state, this particular state, that you know what the truth is. And at the same time, while knowing what the truth is, you're concealing the truth. That's basically what he's saying. He says, وَمَعْنَهُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ الْحَقِّ. What is meant by this part over here is that you know what the truth really is. He says, ويجوز أن يكون المعنى وأنتم تعلمون ما في ذلك من الضرر العظيم على الناس من إضلالهم عن الهدى المفضي بهم إلى النار. He says that what it can also mean, it's permissible and possible that the meaning of وأنتم تعلمون and you know, what it can mean is that you know by doing this what are the great harms that will befall the people. من إضلالهم عن الهدى, from misguiding the people, firstly, from the truth. Al-mufti bihim ila an-nar, which causes the people, which will take the people towards Jahannam. In salaku ma tubdunahu lahum min al-batili, al-mashubi binaw'in min al-haqi, liturawijuhu alayhim. Meaning that in salaku ma tubdunahu lahum, if they follow this path which you are showing them of the falsehood which is mixed with a type of truth there, and you now promote these sort of things to them, and they now follow it, then this firstly is going to lead them astray from the truth, and it will lead them towards Jahannam. So this is what you know, وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, and you know this is what is the tafsir over here. You know that this is the end result of it, so why are you doing it? That's basically what's being said here. He goes further, he says, وَالْبَيَانُ الْإِضَاحِ, that al-bayan means Bayan in the sense here is, as you say, al-idah means to make something clear. So be clear about it, be explicit about it, don't hide. And he says, وَعَكْسُهُ الْكِتْمَانُ وَخَلْطُ الْحَقِّ بِالْبَاطِلِ, that the opposite of idah, the opposite of being clear and straightforward and explicit, is to conceal and to mix truth with falsehood. So you are being commanded with idah and you are forbidden from kitman and takhleed. The final portion, he goes further, he says, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ قَالَ مُقَاتِلَ أَمَرَهُمْ أَيُّ صَلُّوا مَعَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. the next ayah, which was ayah number 43, wherein Allah said, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآدُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. Imam Muqatil, rahimahullah, he had commented, he said that Allah had commanded the people that they should perform salah with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The next part, وَآدُوا الزَّكَاةَ, and they give zakah, أَمَرَهُمْ أَن يُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ أَي يَدْفَعُونَهَا إِلَى النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were, that Allah commanded them to give the zakah, meaning to give it to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the last part, وَرْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ أَمَرَهُمْ أَن يَرْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ مِنْ أُمَّةِ مُحَمَّدٍ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يَقُولُ كُونُوا مَعَهُمْ وَمِنْهُمْ. He says in the last part of the ayah, وَرْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ, he says that Allah commanded them now, in addition to the previous two, that they should yarka'u ma'a raki'in, that they should make ruku' with those of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who make ruku', meaning, as he say, aqalu, yakunu ma'ahum wa minhum, be from them, with them, and amongst them. Don't... Okay, question over here. Are these ayahs referring to Muslims in general? Ayah number 42 and 43. When it comes to the... If you look at these two ayat in particular, it's the if you only look from the sababun nuzul perspective, that the reason of revelation of these two ayat, then the people who are being directed, who this ayat are being directed at, are the Jews. These two ayat, along with many others, they are directed at them primarily. They are the main people being addressed in these ayat. However, as we know, the usul of tafsir that العبرة بعموم اللفظ لا لخصوص السبب, that we take the lesson and the ruling and benefit we take from it from the unrestricted nature of the words, not from the specific nature of the reason for the ayah being revealed. So although the ayah was revealed regarding Jews, but the same command will apply to the Muslims as well. Obviously we know cloaking truth and falsehood is something impermissible. Concealing the truth is something impermissible, especially more so if it is something that you know the truth and then you are concealing it. Establishing salah, it's a command that we have to do. Giving zakah, a command that we have to do. وَرْكَعُ مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ, performing ruku' with those who make ruku' is also another command for us as well. So everything, you can say, like it's so just so applicable to the Jews, in like manner it is just so applicable to the Muslims as well. So that was كُونُوا مَعَهُمْ وَمِنْهُمْ, be among with them and amongst them, meaning become a Muslim and be with the Muslims. Don't stay here now on as a Jew and everything of that sort. So that then is the end of the tafsir of ayat number 42 and 43. Moving on now would be onwards to ayah number 44. It's all still leading up from the same point, all the ayat addressed to the Jews. So in ayah number 44, Allah says, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابَ أَفَلَا تَعَقِلُونَ, that do you command the people with goodness, وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ, but you forget about yourselves, meaning you're telling people to do good, but you don't do it yourselves, وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ, and you read the book, meaning you read the Torah, you know what is written in there. So that's the statement Allah says to them, and then says, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ, do you not have any sense, do you not have any understanding? How is it possible that you are doing something like this? That you are telling the people, go and do this, and then you are doing the opposite yourself. What happened was that the Jews, there were certain people amongst the Jews that when people used to come ask them about, obviously the Jews were seen as the people of knowledge, the people of intelligence and things of that sort. So many people from the Arabs and others used to come and ask the Jews, like, what's the right way, where do we go from here, all those sort of things. So they would come and ask, that's when now in the when Islam had just was, so to say, new at the time, so they would come and ask that the Jews now, what should we do and everything like this. So the Jews في certain Jews, they would say, no, he is the final messenger and everything of the sort like that. You must join him and everything. But they themselves did not join Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They themselves did not accept Islam. They were sending other people, you go accept Islam, you go become a Muslim, you commanding them with goodness. But watansawna anfusakum, how is it that you forget about your own self, your own selves, that you do not accept Islam yourselves, but rather you are telling other people to go ahead and do it. So thus again was not every Jew. This was a portion amongst the Jews. The others were those who would conceal the truth and mix it with falsehood and all those sort of other types there. But this ayah now is addressing another group from the Jews, those who would command people with good but would not do it themselves. So moving on to the tafsir of this ayah over here, he says, ma'anahu, كيف يليق بكم يا معشر أهل الكتاب وأنتم تأمرون الناس بالبر وهي جماع الخير أن تنسوا أنفسكم فلا تأتمرون بما تأمرون الناس به. He says that the meaning of this ayah here is, how is it fitting and possible for you, O people of the Ahlul Kitab, people of the book, وأنتم تأمرون الناس بالبر, that you are commanding people with bir. And he says bir is what? He says wahuwa jama'ul khair, it is all goodness together. So you are commanding people with all types of goodness. Antanso anfusakum, that you forget about yourselves. Fala ta'tamiruna bima ta'muruna an-nas bih, so you do not act upon that which you are commanding other people with. Wa antum ma'a dhalik tatluna al-kitaba wa ta'lamuna ma fihi 'ala man qassara fi awamirillah. And over and above that, you have another factor, is that you read the book, meaning the Torah, and you know what is mentioned in it about the one who neglects and who neglects the commands of Allah. So you know that this is a command which Allah has commanded you with, and you are intentionally neglecting and turning away from it. You know what is the end result and the punishment and the severity of such a thing. So why are you doing such a thing? Then Allah says, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ مَا أَنْتُمْ صَانِعُونَ بِأَنفُسِكُمْ. Do you not have any intelligence? Do you not understand? Meaning, it says here, مَا أَنْتُمْ صَانِعُونَ بِأَنفُسِكُمْ, what you are doing to your own selves. فَتَنْتَبِهُ مِنْ رَقَدَتِكُمْ وَتَتَبَصَّرُ مِنْ عَمَايَتِكُمْ. He says that you, are you not aware of what you are doing? That you wake up from your sleep and you see from your blindness. Meaning, take the blinkers off your eyes and wake up, stop sleeping, look at what you are doing and come onto the right path. He says, وَهَذَا كَمَا قَالَ قَتَادَ فِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ قَالَ كَانَ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلَ يَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالطَّاعَةِ اللَّهِ وَبِتَقْوَاهُ وَيُخَالِفُونَ فَعَيَّرَهُمُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He says that, okay, question over here. So the Jews acknowledge Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be the final Rasul. Yes, most definitely. These Jews had admitted that yes, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the final messenger. They know it, but they refused to accept Islam. This again was a group. Another group came out and rejected Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, there's a famous incident that the Jews used to come every day and they were sitting and waiting when the final Nabi is going to come, all the signs and everything were in place. And then when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, then they all rejected. Despite the fact that all the signs were found within Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they wanted the final Nabi to be a Jew. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came as an Arab, they refused to accept. So that it was now a group of the Jews who believed that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was indeed the final Nabi, but they just simply refused to accept Islam. They are these people who used to command people with good but forget about their own selves. And then there were the others who were just simply rejecters of Islam in its entirety. Okay, so we were here on the topic of Imam Qatada rahimahullah, where he says, وَهَذَا كَمَنْ قَالَ قَتَادَ فِي قَوْلِ تَعَالَى, that this is what Imam Qatada rahimahullah had said regarding the ayah, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ, do you command the people with goodness and forget about your own selves? He says, كَانَ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلَ, that the Banu Israel, they used to command people with the obedience of Allah, meaning, وَبِتَقْوَاهُ, that they would tell the people, you must fear Allah, you must obey Allah, and everything of the sort like this. But وَيُخَالِفُونَ, but for their own selves, they would contradict it. So they would say, go make salah, go give zakah, go become a Muslim, go do this, go do that, go worship Allah and things, and then they would go and do the entire opposite of it. So فَعَيَّرَهُمُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. So Allah like condemned them and found fault with them. Now obviously in this ayah here like this, by telling them, do you command people with good? Or rather you say Allah took them to task in this ayah by asking them, do you command people with good but forget about your own selves? Do you not have any understanding? He says, وَقَالَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَيْ تَتْرُكُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابَ أَفَلَا تَعَقِلُونَ أَيْ تَنْهَوْنَ النَّاسَ عَنِ الْكُفْرِ بِمَا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ النُّبُوَّةِ وَالْعَهْدِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَتَتْرُكُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَيْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَكْفُرُونَ بِمَا فِيهَا مِنْ عَهْدِي إِلَيْكُمْ فِي تَصْدِيقِ رَسُولِي وَتَنْقُضُونَ مِيثَاقِي وَتَجْحَدُونَ مَا تَعْلَمُونَ مِنْ كِتَابِي. He says that Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, commenting on this ayah, he says, وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَيْ تَتْرُكُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ, meaning you leave your own selves, meaning you command other people to do the good, but you leave your own selves out from those who do good, meaning they must do good, not you. وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابَ أَفَلَا تَعَقِلُونَ أَيْ تَنْهَوْنَ النَّاسَ عَنِ الْكُفْرِ, you prohibit people from committing kufr, بِمَا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ النُّبُوَّةِ وَالْعَهْدِ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ, that, and this is what I was mentioning earlier, they would prevent people from kufr because they had the nubuwah previously, they had the pledge in the Torah, they knew everything about the final Nabi, then the Torah and the books that they had were from the Anbiya alayhi salam, the previous Anbiya that they had followed and stuff like this. So they had the knowledge by them. So they would prevent people from committing kufr with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But وَتَتْرُكُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ, but they would leave out their own selves. So they would send other people, go off there, go become a Muslim, but they themselves would not go become Muslims. أي وَأَنْتُمْ تَكْفُرُونَ بِمَا فِيهَا مِنْ عَهْدِي إِلَيْكُمْ فِي تَصْدِيقِ رَسُولِي. But وَأَنْتُمْ تَكْفُرُونَ, that you tell people to go do all this goodness, but you rejected what is in your own books, my pledge, which I had taken from you, that you are to accept my Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَتَنْقُضُونَ مِيثَاقِي, and you break the pledge which you have taken with me. وَتَجْحَدُونَ مَا تَعْلَمُونَ مِنْ كِتَابِي, and you reject that which you know to be from my kitab, meaning you know that this is from the side of Allah in your own books, and then you still go ahead and you reject it. وقال الضحاك عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما في هذه الآية يقول أتأمرون الناس بالدخول في دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وغير ذلك مما أمرتم به من إقام الصلاة وتنسون أنفسكم. Imam al-Dhahak rahimahullah, he commented, or rather he reports from Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, who commented on this ayah saying, do you command the people to enter into the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and all the other goodness which you command them with, from establishing salah and etc., but watansawna anfusakum, but you forget about your own selves? Alright, so for tonight inshallah, we're going to be stopping on this point over here. Next week inshallah, we will continue on from Qala Abu Darda radiyallahu anhu. But for now, we will be ending at this point here, which is on page 59, at the end of the first paragraph of Tafseer from ayah number 44. So That will be for next week, inshallah, when we continue on that point. And seeing as we have no further, or rather, you say we have no questions regarding anything mentioned in the lesson, so inshallah, we will end on this point here and continue next week. So until then, we will end for now and we say, Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad, subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.